cell phones are distracting was.
Oh, you're okay. Being sarcastic? Oh. You gotta let me know.
Okay, so the word of the day, you probably missed it, is dong.
Dong,
yeah. So I'm gonna tell you, okay, first, the word of the day is dong, because I was reading a title, okay, speaking of, like, articles that are, like, miswritten and blah, blah,
yeah.
Okay, there was a thing on a news channel, I won't say the name of the channel, but here, how will you hold the
camera? Yeah, okay, here you go, John.
Okay.
Let's get you on some video here.
So, on a news channel, there was the headline, it was about that oil company. I'm going to mention the name anyway. It's not like it's a secret.
Who doesn't know, yeah.
So, the title read, is BP dong enough? And I was like, because sometimes there are typos, but that's like the best one ever.
That's a bad one, yeah. That's right up there.
And it was there for a while. It took like about a minute for somebody to change it. But they did.
Yeah.
So I'm just like, okay, is BP dong enough? And I'm like, that's cute. And I thought, well, the word of the day should be dong as well.
Okay.
I looked up the word, and dong is actually a currency in North Vietnam.
Oh.
Yeah.
Interesting.
At least according to my World Book Encyclopedic Dictionary.
Well, that's pretty reliable, I'd
say. Yeah, even though it's out of date, it was published the year I was born, like 50 years ago.
Well, I'm sure the dong is still a strong, thriving currency. Sorry, where was it? North Korea?
North Vietnam,
okay.
Yeah. Actually, I looked in another dictionary and it said it's in a country formerly known as Cambodia.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. I didn't even know Cambodia wasn't a country anymore. But
me neither. I think they had some problems there, though. From what I recall. Yeah, I think they had a little bit of issues over in Cambodia. Not to make light of their situation.
Right. No, we're not. Yeah, we're not making. I'm actually making light of my ignorance to world issues at this point.
Yeah.
But anyway, which is not to be taken lightly.
Absolutely.
You should be up to snuff on world issues.
Yeah.
Like, you know, like the fact that France is not in the World Cup anymore. And they shouldn't have even been in there because they used a handball to score a goal to get in there.
Bunch of cheaters.
Yeah.
It's not his fault. He was drunk on wine.
Okay.
Anyways, moving on.
So the thing is, I'm like, dong, though, like, in like, slang can be so many things, like...
Yeah.
Right? But then there's another... Okay, yeah, so we'll stay away from that.
Yeah, that's the easy road. We don't want to go down that road.
Too easy. Let's take the higher road here.
Yeah.
Okay? There's a word some of you folks may know, onomatopoeia.
Ah.
It's an onomatopoeic word because dong represents... dong
on a bell,
like ding dong.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm not sure exactly how they got ding dong for the name of a.
Well, is ding a word then too? I guess.
Yeah.
Would be an automatic automatopoeic word.
Yes. Oh. Yeah. But then there are ding dongs like candies, right?
Candies,
the snacks. The
cakes or whatever. Yeah.
Yeah. The candy cakes or whatever.
Yeah.
Okay. So yeah, I'm not sure why those are called ding dongs, but. Whatever, maybe you eat them and you're like, ding dong, I don't know.
Oh, I don't know about that. I hope not. I don't want to ever see anybody do that anyways. That'd be really weird. Ding dong. Okay. That was good.
Okay. So and then I got one more here because even though it's not related, I think subliminally, correct me if I'm wrong, and then I'm going to grab the camera from you, but then think of the word or the name... Donkey Kong.
Mm-hmm.
And this is going to sound bad.
You're going to say, no, you're not. Just do it. Just do it. You're in too deep now. There's no turning back, buddy.
It's like, and something's been like when you, there's a saying like, well, this is going to be big like Donkey Kong.
Got it going on like Donkey Kong.
Yeah. But then, I think subliminally, just because we have somewhat dirty minds sometimes, you think of Donkey Kongs.
I can't believe you.
Donk.
Dude.
Being really large, and it's a big deal.
Anybody listening right now should definitely look at this video. Watch Johnny go absolutely crazy.
Okay, so give me your perspective there, Klaus.
What am I
that supposed to say about that? Talking about Donkey Kong. I thought you were going to go with Donkey Kong or something. I don't know. I thought you were making some reference to the dong at the beginning of Donkey.
Oh.
Yeah, but no, you just went a completely different direction. I wasn't expecting it at all, to be perfectly honest.
I wasn't really expecting that either. It just kind of came to me.
This is a tough one.
Okay, but to tell you the truth, I was actually quite surprised that in the dictionary, there are so many words that have been incorporated from slang and stuff,
yeah,
that dong was still there just as the currency of a North Vietnam country.
It's in the dictionary or the encyclopedia?
In the World Book Encyclopedia, yeah, dictionary.
It's in there, yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know. That's weird. I thought it was always just... Well, I mean, there's the obvious application of the word dong. But who really uses that word anyways? I mean, how... You picked a weird one today, John. Who uses the word dong anymore?
I don't know. Isn't that common?
I don't think so, man. Maybe in your head.
Okay. Well, okay, then we're just gonna move on from here. Okay. So here, take that. Focus on the record here. Okay. We're playing Tiësto featuring Nelly Furtado again. We play a different mix every week. This is Canadian content because... This is Canadian content. This is Canadian content because Nelly Furtado co-wrote the song, which has like 20 words in it anyway, whatever. But she also does the vocals, and therefore it's Canadian content. So we're gonna play this, and one mistake we've been making, like when I played C is for Cookie on this show, I stopped recording before the song really got going.
Oh yeah.
Which is a shame because people watching the video didn't get to listen to C is for Cookie, which is really awesome.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna let people listen to this for a bit. Okay, so just keep rolling, and we'll be back at you soon. But for now, just listen to Nelly Furtado and Tiësto with the song called Who Wants to Be Alone? And I like that again. Check your notes. I've mentioned it before, but you might have forgotten. It's the Robbie Rivera Juicy remix that I'm going to play now. It's just funny because Robbie Rivera is a DJ, and he's remixing a song made by a DJ. I just think it's funny. That's just my thing. Okay. So here it is. Who Wants to Be Alone? Enjoy. Mind holding that?
No.
Okay.